Well, hello there, friends, and welcome back to the Zoukline. I'm Adam. About a year ago, I recorded a discussion with dancer and martial artist Tim Wegert. At the time, he posted a video on social media threatening the organizer of Interfusion, a popular mixed discipline event in Virginia. In this era of frequent mass violence, the short video grabbed lots of attention and caused the portion of the dance community to be concerned for their safety. So as a Hail Mary attempt to document and resolve the perceived danger, I reached out to Tim and set up a last-minute video interview. In the uninterrupted two-hour video with many unexpected turns, Tim shared his grievances and aspirations alongside his partner, Carla. And this is where we left off previously. If you'd like to see that video, I've left a link in the description. It's long, but I think the journey is worth it. So in the end, after talking through his grievances, it should come as no surprise that Tim attempted to make an appearance at Interfusion against the organizer's wishes. On January 12, 2023, Tim arrived at the Crystal Gateway Marriott Hotel in Arlington, Virginia, and was promptly arrested. He was booked in Fulvana County Court with two counts of stalking and two counts of felony bomb threats. After those charges, something allegedly happened on January 13, 2023, while he was incarcerated. He ended up receiving several additional counts, which included two counts of attempted prisoner escape, four counts of assault and battery, and two counts of disarming a law enforcement or correctional officer of a stun gun. Since then, the legal process has run its course, and Tim was convicted on many of these counts. Now, with the understanding that I, Adam, do not fully comprehend the Virginia legal system or its online case tracking database, from my calculations, it appears that Tim was sentenced to approximately 2 years and 9 months of incarceration. Although it should be mentioned that there is some interesting legal math taking place with these cases. Strictly speaking, he was sentenced to 33 years for these acts. However, 30.25 of them were suspended. And at the time of last year's video, Tim was also facing 4 charges in North Carolina and his 6 felony counts in Florida, as referenced in the video, where he mentions he was facing 80 years of prison time in Florida. Although the North Carolina charges are no longer showing up in any of my public record searches, the significant Florida charges are still pending. So it appears that Tim will be tangled in the legal system for the foreseeable future. This is no doubt a terrible and difficult time for Tim, his family, and the broader community. And I also want to acknowledge the victims of these crimes. Maintaining a safe society is difficult, and I don't envy those whose duty it is to determine who and what is safe. In any case, I hope everyone can now have some sense of peace. Now, throughout this process, I reached out to Tim a number of times to get his perspective, and much to my surprise, I heard back. This is what he had to say. Dear Adam, I was surprised to hear from you. Thank you for caring and reaching out. Your email was a reminder for me that there are many people and things outside my current situation that I care about deeply. You ask how I'm doing. Well, the truth is, the last 4.5 months have been the most lonely, difficult, and harsh of my life. I would not wish my current situation on my enemies. It's a daily battle. But I am managing and am more than committed to seeing this season through to the other side. I'm incredibly grateful for family, especially parents, and a few core friends who have been supportive during this time. Yes, there have been developments with my case, but with things still in the works, I feel better about waiting till the situation is over before sharing more of the story. Carla is well. Back in Argentina for the time being, I miss her tremendously. I have lots I could share, but I'm still deep in the process, challenges, and learning lessons that this season has surrounded me with. I miss dance so much, and hope the scene is progressing and enjoying to the fullest. After this season, I'd love to connect more and share more fully if you would like. I appreciate the thoughts and concerns and really do hope everyone is doing well. Much love, God bless, and happy dancing, Tim. A month later, after his conviction, late last year, I reached out again for more comment. This is what he had to say. Hello, Mr. Adam. It's kind of you to reach out and for your interest in my situation. I hope you had an amazing Thanksgiving and that life is going smoothly and safely for you. I feel that I am currently swimming across an ocean. Unfortunately, I'm still unaware of how long I will be enduring this hardship for. Because of the unknown and my inability to be involved with the people and scenes that I love, I really have no wish to share the details of my situation, especially publicly. This is my life for a while. Again, I still don't know for how long. It's going to be best for me to disappear for a while until I have the ability to move on from this season. I hope you can understand. All the best, Tim. So that's it. Tim will likely be dealing with the consequences for quite some time. And the reality is, it's unlikely that many of us will see him during our dance lifetime. So if you're a friend of Tim's and would like to message him or be in contact with him, he did say he would like to disappear, but if you know him well and think that he would like to hear from you, you can chat with him by signing up on securistech.net. And from there, you can search for his name and send him a message. There is a cost to send messages, but it's very inexpensive. It's comparable to buying a stamp from the post office. If there's more significant news on this topic, I'll be sure to post about it. But in the meantime, please come back for more episodes of the Zoukline. I have lots more in store. And if you haven't heard or seen it yet, I recently did an interview with Anthony Umina a few months ago. And it was apparently so spicy that it could not be, it was kicked from YouTube. It was removed. So I had to move it to Spotify. There's a link for that in the description. But before we go, I have one more bit of somber news. A bright light was lost in the Zouk community recently. JC Arzaga passed away January 5th, 2023. There will be a funeral mass in Los Angeles on January 22nd. You can look in the description for more details. He will very much be missed. I'm going off script here for a second. He was a pillar of the Zouk community on the West Coast and in Brazil, and just a lovely spirit, and his absence will be felt by a lot of people, and he was very much loved. So we will miss you, JC. As you can imagine, researching and following this case and all the other projects for this past year took a significant amount of time and effort. So please be sure to support the channel by doing the YouTube thing and liking and subscribing, and please tell your friends. And if you want to join the discussion or just connect with a broader Zouk community, feel free to join the Zoukline Discord channel as well as the Zoukline Facebook group. I greatly value your feedback and ideas for future episodes. So thanks for joining. And remember, tomorrow is not guaranteed. So if able, call your parents and hug your friends. See you later. Sem eu ver, talvez seja cedo.